What we're going to go through here is some of the basic policies that you can set up inside of Chrome, which can make your life a whole lot easier. And I really love Google Chrome and obviously the G Suite and the Google ecosystem. And what some of these policies do is they bridge the gap between using G Suite for just administrative purposes and then actually utilizing G Suite as like enterprise solution for your business. And so what we're really talking about here is using G Suite to perform some mild computer management type tasks. They may be things like changing the desktop background on a Chromebook, adding or removing features inside of Google Chrome. What it also allows you to do is even like push down apps and plugins, which I'm going to take you guys through. And so this is really useful if you've got a number of employees, they're all working in your business, and you want to have some way of kind of managing what they have access to within inside the Chrome browser. Now, of course, if you're using Chromebooks or Chrome boxes, which are Chrome OS devices, you're going to have much more control over what you can do. But for anyone who's using a Windows machine or a Mac machine, you can actually control their Chrome browser as long as they're signed in with their business G Suite account. So for anyone who's signed in, then you're actually going to get access to be able to use some of these tools and some of these policies. And I'm going to show you some of the simplest and most basic ones that are super duper useful. So in the admin panel, if you've not been there yet before, it's admin.google.com. Pretty straightforward to get to. And for us to get to our Chrome management, we want to go to the devices menu. Now, this is where you can manage a multitude of different devices. There are actually options to manage mobile devices. So there's a small level of management available for mobile devices. And then you also have available the ability to manage obviously Chromebooks and Chrome boxes. So we can push down hardware-based policies to those. But what we're going to be working with today is the Chrome user policies. And the Chrome user policies get applied to anyone that's signed into a Chrome browser. Now, who is signed into a Chrome browser and how do you do that, you may ask? Well, you just click into Chrome. So you can see in the top right-hand corner of Google Chrome, and this will be the same whether you're on a Windows machine or a Mac, you will have there the little man. And with the little man, you can click that button and then sign in with your business account. And so once you sign in with your business account, that's going to mean that it synchronizes all of the settings and policies from your business account to that Chrome browser. Now, you want to make sure that you're doing that with a business account and not with like a personal Gmail, because what that gives you the ability to do is to actually have all of those policies from the business pushed down to your machine. And also when you sign in with your business account, obviously it's going to synchronize your bookmarks to any computer that you're using. What we find is some customers accidentally will sign in on one computer with their Gmail account, like a personal account, and then another computer with their business account, and things end up getting a little bit messy or out of sync. So you want to make sure you're signed in, and importantly, you want to make sure all of your staff are signed in as well. Super important that all your staff stay signed in with Google Chrome, because otherwise they're not going to get these policies pushed down. So that's what it looks like to get signed in, and that's the number one step to make sure that it's working properly. Okay, so you may notice there's a new menu item right down the bottom here that says Windows settings, and Google are actually beginning to let us have some settings and control over Windows desktops, which is pretty interesting and I'd say pretty awesome as well. What that means is we're starting to kind of like bridge the gap into the arena of Microsoft's Active Directory product, which is the product that kind of runs on a server and then manages all of the desktops, logins, printer sharing, credentials, desktop settings, and all those kind of things. And obviously this is all part of G Suite. There's no extra charge for any of these features. And so the cool thing is we're starting to see Google really try and replace that corporate server model with building in what would normally be happening in a paid Active Directory licensing scheme for free with G Suite, which is pretty darn cool. And so myself, having managed literally thousands of different businesses' computer network, allowing us to use a tool like this to manage desktops without having to do any of the Microsoft stuff is just an absolute godsend. And we're really excited to see Google's development in this area. And even though it's not always relevant to, you know, small businesses, as new features come to this style of management with Windows, then we will be sure to create videos and share what's going on there. Let's get into our actual policies now. So I mentioned that these are user policies. They're not computer policies or device policies. Now, what that means is it's going to be implemented on the user level. There are some device policies that you can create for Chromebooks, and it might be like change the background picture for anyone that uses this device. That is certainly an option. But the user-based policies mean that it's going to be tied tied to user account. And it's also going to be tied to the organizational unit that someone is in within the G Suite account. But most of our audience are small business owners and don't even bother setting up different groups and organizational units inside the admin panel. So we're just going to keep things super simple for now. So let's go into our Chrome devices here. And that's just going to kind of show you what the Chrome device menu looks like. So if you're managing Chromebooks or Chrome boxes, they're going to show up here, and the organizational units that I talked about actually appear here on the left hand side. Then we're going to go to our device management menu, and then after we've opened up there on the left hand side, you can see here we have device settings and then we have mobile settings. So we need to go into Chrome management. So after we've opened up Chrome management, this will allow us to start to set some of our policies. So you can see here we've got device management, managed browsers, which is a paid license for Google Chrome, gives you some extra features, not really relevant, and we'll cover that in a different video. But the ones that I want to show off today are in user and browser setting. And so inside user and browser settings, you'll be able to see here we've got a bunch of different options. And so I'm going to scroll down and show you some of those options. Don't waste your time trying to read or understand every single one of them, because there's a whole bunch, but I'm going to show you guys some basic ones that are the most powerful. Now, first up, my favorite one is to create a shared bookmarks folder for everyone inside the company. And so shared bookmarks allow you to push down a set of company-wide bookmark to everyone in the business. And so you can see here that I've called mine links, and it just appears in my bookmarks menu. So anyone in the business who is signed in with a business account is automatically gonna have their bookmarks showing up there. So you can see here, I've got all of the links, got links to our GeniusNet, which is our intranet site, got a link to Asana, got a link to the partner console, that's important, link to our website. Basically, whatever you want, it might be Xero.com, whatever, you can push down links and have them available for everyone. And so with that links menu, let me show you how we go and set it up. We're going to go to user settings, and it's actually called managed bookmarks. So if you search for bookmark, you can see here managed bookmarks is the setting. So it's the only one that it's brought up. And here I can actually choose locally applied or inherited from default. Basically means, do you want this to just automatically follow what Google's recommendation is, or do you want to locally apply it? So we want locally applied. Locally applied means that we're going to set, configure the policy. That's pretty basic there. And then all we have to do is we give the folder a name. I use links because it's nice and short. And then we actually start adding URLs into the links here. So that's pretty straightforward. You just hit the plus button there. And let's say, for example, if I wanted to add new URL and it was zero, I would add zero there, and then I'd add the URL zero.com. And then all I need to do is go ahead and click save. And then basically, as long as I'm at the top level of my company, which I am right now, when I hit save, it's going to automatically push that down to everyone's browser. Now, it may take up to 30 minutes for any policy change that you make to be applied. So if it doesn't appear immediately, it can take up to 30 minutes, particularly if you've got a lot of users. But if this is a change that you're just making on a small account, and I'm talking about like sub 50 users on your account, they tend to go through pretty much instantaneously. Okay, so that's managed bookmarks. We're going to set up a number of bookmarks here, and they are going to be automatically applied. This is another one that I like to do, is the bookmarks bar. And so the bookmarks bar along the top there, you can actually choose whether or not it is visible or not. Now, personally, I like to keep mine hidden, but you may wish to show the bookmarks bar for all of your staff. Now, I've got a pretty tech savvy crew that work for me, and so I can kind of get away with our team just having an expectation that their bookmarks will be available to them no matter what. As soon as they open a new tab, it's going to show all the bookmarks here. But as you can see here, when I'm browsing around, it doesn't show them. You may choose to force the bookmarks bar on everyone. And if you want to force the bookmarks bar, what it means is you can make it always available for everyone. So let's go ahead and search for that one again. So it's under the user experience menu. If you search for the word bar, I can either allow the user to decide, I can disable the bookmarks bar, or I can force enable it. So we're basically forcing enabling it to appear for everyone. I may choose to switch on if I had maybe a less tech savvy team and I wanted them to always see their bookmarks along the top and always see that links folder that we just created. That would be one way of ensuring that people are actually using it and they've got access to everything that they need.